Hey everybody, I am Jamie Troll. I am a CPA, a profit strategist, and a financial literacy coach, and I have been following all things stimulus for you guys. So I wanted to bring a quick update today because we had a lot of information that dropped today. It's June 17th when I am recording this. Early in the wee hours of the morning, the Treasury decided to bestow some new guidance on us. So I much appreciate this. Usually they like to hit us right at like Friday night when I'm sitting down to watch an episode of a show. So I'm actually kind of glad that it came out this morning. But there is a lot in here. But I wanted to make a specific video just for you self-employed people. So who I'm talking to? Self-employed, sole proprietors, independent contractors, those who do not have employees. Your guys are typically probably sole proprietors or LLCs in your taxation status. You probably file a Schedule C. So that's who I'm talking to today. I'm making other videos for those of you who are employers or S-Corps. I'm going to be making other videos to describe the changes to you. But today I just wanted to focus on my self-employed folks because there are some really important updates that you guys need to be aware of that are really positive for you actually in the new application. So this morning, Treasury dropped two new applications. You heard it. I said two. There is one regular long form application, which is more similar to what we saw before with some changes due to the ability to change and select 24 weeks. And there is also a easy application. And this easy application is for people who essentially are either don't have employees or they meet one of the safe harbor requirements as an employer. But we're not gonna talk about that because safe harbor doesn't matter to you guys who are my self-employed folks because you don't have any employees anyway. So what this actually says is what amount shall be eligible for forgiveness. The amount of loan forgiveness can be up to the full principal amount of the loan plus accrued interest. The actual amount of loan forgiveness will depend in part on the total amount spent over the 24-week period beginning on the date your PPP loan is disbursed. On, and we're going to come down to point two because point one really more refers to people who have employees. Point two is what is important for you guys, my sole proprietors. Owner compensation replacement calculated based on 2019 net profit with forgiveness of such amounts limited to 8 weeks worth of 2019 net profit for an 8 week covered period or 2.5 months worth of 2019 net profit for a 24-week covered period. Okay, what does all this mean? Lots of numbers, lots of words. What this is really saying, okay, when they're talking about 2019 net profit, they are talking about Schedule C of your 2019 tax return, line 31. For most of you, that was probably what they used to actually calculate out the amount of PPP loan you received, okay? So you're gonna take that same number, whatever your net profit was that you made last year, that was considered kind of your payroll for the year. And if you decide to go with the 8 week time period, which was the old time period, you're gonna take 8/52 of that. So basically you're gonna take your 2019 net profit, divide by 52, multiply by eight, that's your 8 weeks of pay. The maximum is 15,385. Why is the max 15,385? Well, because the max Schedule C line 31 you can use is 100,000. So if you made more than 100,000, congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Moneybags, you can only max out at 100,000. So they take that 100,000, divide by 52, multiply by eight, that's how they get to the 15,385. So it's whichever one is smaller, right? 8 weeks of your pay based on your net income or 15,385, okay? So that's if you take the 8 weeks. And some of you may want to take the 8 weeks, that may be an option, but I'm gonna talk about here in a minute how you might be able to choose between those things, okay? So if you take the 8 weeks, more than likely, depending on the loan that you had, you might actually have some additional money left over that you could then spend on rent and utilities and things like that to get forgiven. But if you took the 8 week period, the max you can do is the 8/52 of your 2019 net profit. But here's the new thing. So PPP Flexibility Act that was passed a couple of weeks ago almost now said essentially that you could use it over 24 weeks. And the big question was to self-employed people, what does that mean for me, right? So what that really means is the total amount that you can take and be forgiven for as owner payroll to yourself from PPP is now, if you choose 24 weeks, 2019 net profit, Schedule C line 31, divide by 12 times 2.5. Because now we're talking about 2.5 months of payroll. The weeks, months thing drives me moderately batty, but you get the point. So now we're taking 2.5 months worth. Why 2.5 months? Well, that's what the basis of the loan was to begin with, right? So the max loan, if you didn't have any employees, the maximum loan you should have gotten was 2.5 times your average monthly payroll calculated off of your net profit. Now, some banks didn't do that. Some banks gave too much. Some banks did it off of gross income or 1099s when they really weren't supposed to. So unfortunately, if you got more than 2.5 months worth of your net profit, you can't really benefit from that necessarily. You can't take more of that. You can't base what you pay yourself in your own payroll on what the bank gave you if you use 1099s. You have to use that net profit. So if you haven't filed your taxes, you're going to need to. They're due July 15th anyway. So make sure you get those taxes filed so that you know what your owner pay is. So those are really, that's really how you're gonna calculate it out. So what does that mean? Well, if you got the right amount of your loan, right? If your loan was based off of 2.5 times your average monthly payroll based on your 2019 Schedule C net profit, that's your whole loan that gets forgiven then as owner pay if you pick the 24-week option, okay? So then you don't have to fool around with making sure you have rent or trying to deduct a part of your home utilities, which is a little bit questionable whether you can do that anyway, right? So it's much simpler. And then it allows you to file the Schedule EZ, okay? So either way you go, because you don't have employees, you are going to be able to file this abbreviated, much, much, much abbreviated form for forgiveness. So this is going to be your forgiveness application. It's just a one pager now instead of, you know, the 11 pages in the original document. So you've got to fill out some information on your payroll costs and if you are taking any of these other costs, which you don't need to, right? If you pick the 24-month option, you can just put your own payroll costs based on your total calculation that we just talked through. And then it's going to be, the whole thing is going to come out to be forgiven. You're going to have to certify a bunch of different things in here, right? So make sure you read through the certifications. But basically, you're going to be able to get forgiven for the entire amount of the loan. And it's going to be really easy for the banks, too. That's why they call this the easy form, right? It's going to be really easy for you and really easy for the banks. So there's not going to be a whole rigmarole. And so I think this is something that we were really looking to. And I've been talking about the need to have this for a while. So I just feel like somebody listened to me and actually made an easy form. I think this will just be so much easier for processing on both the bank side and you personally. I am going to have a new tracker. So some of you guys already downloaded my PPP tracker, obviously, with the new rules. We're going to be updating it. If you haven't updated it, or if you haven't actually signed up for it, go to balancecfo.com/PPP tracker. And that is where you're going to be able to get on the list to get it. We're currently in the middle of updating it, but if you get this, if you're watching this, depending on when you're watching this, it might already be available. So we're working to get that updated quickly. It will basically fill in this entire application for you. That's really what it will do. So both for self-employed people, and then we have one that's also going to be used for people who have employees to be able to use. So make sure to get on the list to sign up for that so that you can get that as soon as it is ready, and it will make it super easy peasy for you to fill all of this out. Okay. A couple more things on owner pay, just a couple of questions that I typically get all the time with regards to self-employed. Okay. So one of those questions is around, how do I need to prove that I paid myself, right? What do I need to do? Now, when you look at the interim final rule, the original one for sole proprietors that came out on April 14th, which I don't have up right now, but ultimately that one essentially said, look, the calculation for what you are forgiven for as a sole proprietor is a calculation. Sole proprietor or LLC, if you're a Schedule C filer, right? It's a calculation based on your Schedule C. It is not necessarily based on the actual amount of bank transfers you make or checks that you write to yourself, right? And why is that? Well, it doesn't really make any dang sense, in all honesty, for a sole proprietor LLC to actually have to pay themselves that amount of money. What if you need that money in your business, right? What if you have contractors to pay? What if you have bills to pay and you don't have any income to pay them? So it doesn't really make sense, especially given the fact that from a tax perspective, you aren't taxed as a sole proprietor or an LLC when you take that money out of your business, right? So when you're a corporation, S Corp, C Corp, and you pay yourself as a wage, right? You pay yourself actually as an employee, you're taxed on that amount. But for sole proprietors and LLCs, you're not. So it doesn't really make sense to force them to take that money when it's really just a paper transaction anyway. So the thing that would happen, right, if you were forced to write those checks to yourself or transfer that money to yourself, you would but you needed the money in your business that you didn't have, you'd probably just contribute it back into your business, wouldn't you? So it'd just be like this shuffling around game. And so really what the Treasury said is, that's silly. We don't really need you to do that. Here's my caveat to that though. Will some banks get this wrong? I fully expect them to. I fully expect that some banks will ask you for support for your own payroll to yourself as a sole proprietor LLC. Doesn't make any sense, but given what we saw when this all rolled out and how it's very clear that specifically very small businesses, self-employed people, independent contractors, sole proprietors aren't really well understood by the people writing a lot of this stuff and necessarily the banks, I would not be surprised if banks aren't asking you for proof of payroll to yourself. So if you really want to cover yourself, go ahead, write those checks on over to yourself. Honestly, you could probably just transfer it right back if you needed to, okay? But have some support for that transfer of money out of your account if that's something that you're worried about. Or you can actually inquire of your bank and ask them if you're going to need to show anything. In my read of the guidance, you should not need to, but that doesn't mean they won't ask for it. Okay. So another question that I get is, okay, if I'm going to pay myself then, what about timing? So now that I have 24 weeks, what does that mean for timing? Does that mean if I'm going to, you know, pay myself, do I pay myself equally over those 24 weeks? Do I pay myself, you know, since it's 2.5 months worth of payroll, can I wait and not pay myself for a couple of months and then pay myself the last 2.5 months? And that might be beneficial if you're thinking about something like taking PUA, you're taking unemployment, right? That you want to time it such that maybe you start taking PPP and using PPP after you're done with PUA or when you're starting to ramp back up your business, right? Those are things that haven't been addressed as far as timing. And I don't know that they will be. I honestly do not know that they will be. So what I would say is this, come up with a reasonable way to do that. So you can reach out to your state, try to ask them the question. It's always good to ask your actual state unemployment. This isn't something that will impact your PPP forgiveness. It's something that could impact your ability to get unemployment, right? That's really what it is. So you need to reach out to your state unemployment office and ask them, hey, how do I need to recognize this PPP? Do I certify? Do I have to stop certifying? Do I claim it? In a lot of states, you just claim the amount that you're paying yourself on the certification, but it's a little bit strange when now they've extended it to 24 weeks. What does that mean? Do I take the full amount and divide it by 24, right? Is that an option? So I think reaching out and trying to see if you can get an answer from your state, it may not be possible. A lot of times those phone lines are just clogged, but document the effort that you put in. And then come up with what you think is a reasonable approach, whether it's, okay, I'm going to continue to use PUA, and then this is the date that I started using my PPP, and I used it over 2.5 months, or I took my PPP equally over 24 weeks, or whatever you want to kind of document. Or maybe you're at the end of your 8 weeks already, and you're like, well, I already did that, and I claimed it on PUA, so now I need to go be able to go back and get on PUA. So I would document whatever you're doing to make sure that you've shown that you've done your due diligence around the timing of that, okay? Third question I typically get around this is around taxability. So there are some things that are actually a little bit preferential when you're talking about a sole proprietor or LLC that you don't really get some of these benefits if you are a corp. So one of the main benefits that I'm talking about is PPP itself, when it's forgiven, okay, The CARES Act made sure that it was not going to be taxable income. So nope, for no one, it is not taxable income for anybody, regardless of what entity type you are. But then the IRS came out and said, well, you know what? Actually, even though it's not taxable income, now we're not going to let you deduct those expenses that you would normally deduct from it. So meaning you can't deduct your expenses on your taxes like you normally would, right? On your taxes, you have your income, then you deduct your expenses and you pay your taxes on your profit. So by being able to deduct those expenses, it makes your profit lower, which makes your taxes lower, right? If you can't deduct those expenses, your taxes are going to be higher. So ultimately, it kind of like backdoors and makes it a little bit taxable that way. However, here's the rub for sole proprietors, LLCs. Schedule C filers. If you are a Schedule C filer, you don't deduct your pay to yourself anyway. Payroll for yourself is not a deduction on your Schedule C, right? You're just paying on your net profit. It doesn't matter what you take out of your business. Like I said earlier, that's not how you're taxed. You're not taxed when you take it out. You're taxed on whatever your profit is. And because PPP is not taxable income, you guys, right? PPP is not taxable income. They've already said that. Then ultimately, your profit isn't going to be impacted by it. And because your owner pay is not a deduction anyway, it doesn't really matter that you can't take that deduction because you weren't deducting it anyway. So if your official use of PPP funds for the whole thing is to pay yourself, all right, that is going to have absolutely no impact on your profit and therefore absolutely no impact on your taxes. All right, so that is a concept that I think is important to know when you're trying to decide, okay, do I go with the 8-week option, pay myself for 8 weeks, and then use some of it for rent and utilities and things like that, okay? You can do that, but the rent and utilities and other non-payroll things then end up not being deductible on your Schedule C, okay? But if you use the 24-week option and pay yourself the entire amount, right, and don't use any of it officially, right, for rent or payroll or any, or I mean rent or mortgage interest or utilities, right, you just use it all to pay yourself, it has no impact on your taxes, which is a good thing. It doesn't negatively impact your taxes in the way using it to pay rent, et cetera, does, if that makes sense. So I hope that kind of clicks, but ultimately it's just kind of this weird thing with how sole proprietors LLCs are taxed that gives them that benefit where you actually really don't have a tax impact on PPP at all. It's basically just straight up free money to you if you're a sole proprietor LLC and you use the full amount to pay yourself. So that's generally a good thing to do. Important caveat, this is not to be construed as tax or legal advice. This is just me, your friend Jamie, telling you what I would do in that situation. So make sure you sign up for that PPP tracker, balancecfo.com/PPP tracker. Make sure to subscribe to my channel because I'm doing more videos like this and giving you more free stuff. And come join me over in my group, Financial Literacy for Women Business Owners, where we're talking all about this. We're all having conversations about forgiveness and EIDL and unemployment and all the things. So come join the conversation over there. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.